Right, well, hi there, and welcome once again to Burn on Humber. This is going to be a review of a loco. It's the first review that I've done. Thought it was about time that I started doing some. So yeah, this is the first one. So you can see it's going to be a Backman loco, and it's got the logo there, and will in fact be the Class 37. Probably fairly obvious because it will be on the title of the YouTube video. But yeah, it's a Class 37. You can see a slight glimpse of the livery there as it goes past. If we have a look at the label, it's model number 32-381Q. It's a class 37 and subclass 4, and it's a diesel, and it's number 37409. It's in a DRS livery, and its name is Lord Hinton. Yeah, so that's it there, sitting in the box. You can see it's in one of the block of ice sort of style packaging. So we'll get it out of the box and we can have a look at it. It sort of slides out of this part there. And there we have it in the block of ice. Probably it glares a bit in the lighting there. So I'll get it out of the ice as quickly as possible before it melts, I guess. So, yep, so just pop that out. So lean that down. Let gravity do the work for me. Okay, so there it is in the block of ice. Yes, got to slide the overall panel. Okay, so we've got our accessories here. So we've got a couple of snow plows, which I haven't put on it yet. And looks like some various brake hoses and so on that will fit on the front of the loco. Yeah, so there's some accessories. And we'll get it out of the other block of ice. So open it up there. Take that out. You've got to be really careful when you open this up. There's got a couple of aerials that are either side. Quite delicate. You can see there's actually in the packaging itself, there's a little section here that actually protects those aerials. Yeah, so you've got to be careful with that. So I'll take it out there. We shouldn't really grab hold of the livery. Okay, so there we have it. It's DRS Class 37, and it's Lord Hinton. And what's not to like, huh? It's a lovely looking engine. And yeah, really, really like this loco. Right, so let's have a closer look at the loco itself. As you can see, it's a pretty detailed loco. I mean, we've got the aerial at the front here. We were talking about when we were opening it up. And you've got your sort of front lights there. You've got your tail lights. You've got our little warning signs and the individual numbering for the loco there. There's these little blue stars, absolutely no idea what those stand for. And these little white bits, I'm not quite sure what those are either. Maybe somebody can tell me in the comments. And this fitting here as well, which looks like a lamp or something of some sort. You have your sprung buffers. There's a little hose fitting that's fitted just here. And you've got your NEM coupling, which is fitted onto the bogey rather than the body. But yeah, it's NEM, so you can take those out. The door doesn't open at all. But again, you've got your warning symbols here. The grills are moulded on this one. I think there are sort of, I think Heljan have ones which are not moulded, but they look pretty effective. And this grill here is individually fitted rather than sort of being moulded. You've got your nameplate, which has already been fitted on this for Lord Hinton. Your kick plates sort of already like individually fitted as well. And you've got your guard rails on your door and the handle, which has been fitted extra. Again, these little bits here on the bogies have been fitted extra. And just the little bits of individual paint and so on. In here, we've got like the individual colours on, I gather they're caps for some sort of fuel or something as well. And the same with this one in here. You can see the orange in here as well. We'll have a closer look at that in a moment. And then you've also got your fuel tanks. They've got a gauge on there. There's just lots of little bits of detail, like these little symbols and so on. You've got your specification chart down the side here, probably some sort of safety chart or something. Again, you've got your numbers and some sort of lettering around that as well. And then just sort of nice little touches like the orange pinstripe that runs down the side there, just to give it a little bit of highlighting and sort of comes around the front of the window. You've got your horns at the top, and you've also got individually fitted windscreen wipers as well, rather than just being painted onto the windscreens and so on. If I pick it up there, we can sort of have a closer look at some of the aspects. You can see in there, you've got a grille that you can see through. And basically just a lot of detail. If we have a look through here, you can see like all the little bits of detail on here. It's just very, very nicely made. It's got a real weight to it. And the bogies themselves, if we have a look at the undercarriage here, They all three of the wheels are driven, so it's a true sort of Coco class, like its real life counterpart, and it's driven on both bogies. So yeah, it's sort of quite a powerful loco, and with the weight that it has as well, then yeah, I imagine this can pull quite a number of carriages and so on. If we have a look here, you can see that we've got the logo for Backman and Made in China. You've got a couple of switches here, whether or not you want to have the cab lights turn on, whether or not you want to have the tail lights turn on as well, which is quite useful. This one is actually fitted with sound and with lights and so on as well. So that's all sort of controlled by DCC. And overall, it's just got a lot of detail. It's really, really nice. I particularly like this loco. I like how powerful it is, and I particularly also like the sound. I just like the character that they have. In real life, there are actually 309 of them that were made, and they were built between 1960 and 1965, and built in the Vulcan factory in Lancashire, and also in, I think, at Robert Stevenson and Hawthorne's in Darlington. And they're built, as I say, quite a while ago, in the sort of early 60s, and they're still going strong. I mean, they're used by Direct Rail Services and EWS and so on, and it sort of makes them one of the longest serving of the locomotives that are out there on British Rail. Over time, they've sort of been broken down into different subclasses. You've got your 37/0, which is sort of the original design that hasn't really sort of changed at all, and then right through to your subclass 37/9. And they're sort of broken down by sort of different things. Some of them have had the fuel capacity doubled. Others of them have had the English electric motors taken out, or the generators, and replaced with brush alternators. They've had things like extra weight put in them. One of the big differences between a lot of them is the nose end, where you've got things like the head code is split into the two different boxes. And some of them have been fitted with grills and different lighting formations and so on. There's also things like they've been re-bogied. The bogies are actually interchangeable with some of the other classes. I think the 57 and then one or two of the others. Yeah, they've also had things like the ETH fitted onto them. So as trains sort of move from steam heating over to electric heating, they were refitted to provide that. And they're originally called ETH, for electric train heating. Over time, that sort of the electricity that was used for that is used for a whole bunch of other things, like providing air conditioning and lighting and so on. So that got renamed as ETS, for electric train supplies. And yeah, so over time, they've all been fitted with those different things and broken down into the subclasses. Okay, so having a look at the DRS itself, this particular livery I particularly like. It's the compass livery that has all the compass symbol and the full sort of livery right down the side of the loco. There's another simpler one around that has just simply the initials of DRS on the side, but I much prefer this livery. I think it's just a lot more interesting. In terms of DRS, Direct Rail Services, they were formed by British Nuclear Fuels Limited in 1995. And they're very much designed, they started off with, I think it was 5 Class 20s, and for shifting nuclear flasks around. Since then, they, as well as doing the nuclear flasks, they've branched out, they've grabbed themselves Class 47s, Class 57s, Class 66s, and they've also got on order some Class 68s, I think there's 15 of those that are now on order. So yeah, so they'll be expanding their fleet as well. And they've also branched out in terms of what they do as well. They do intermodal freight trains. In fact, they're one of the, I think they're the only publicly owned freight service still in Britain. And they've even done passenger services. They took over doing passenger services for about 6 months at one stage where there was a damaged line. And I think they were on the other side of the damage. So they did the passenger services during that period. And they also run passenger services, I believe, for their own staff and so on as well. Yeah, so that's basically just a close look at the detail. As you can see, it's pretty detailed, good loco, nice and powerful, nice and heavy. And yeah, so as I say, I've got sound on this and all the lighting and so on. So we'll get it all set up. We'll have a listen to the sounds, see why I like the sound almost as much as I like the look of the loco. And yeah, so I'll get all that set up and we'll have a listen. Okay, I'll be back soon. Okay, so that's a run through of all the different sounds. I've got things like, obviously, crank it all up, study it up. Things like the horns and the brake release, the buffer clash, coupling. Got your cab door, your dispatch whistle, your driver's acknowledgement. Things like doing your flange squeal as it sort of goes through the points there and so on, and round the curves. I've also got your compressor and your air cylinder. And then you've also got your rail clack, so as you're travelling along, that sort of obviously speeds up with the speed of the locomotive. You've got things like notchy up and notching down for thrashy and so on. You've also got a fade out function, which drops the sound down a little. I don't think I actually turned that on during it. Basically, to fade it out as if you're going through a tunnel and so on, or if you're just going out through the back scenes into the fiddle yard, so you can still hear it as it disappears, but obviously it's a faded sound. Okay, so that's all the different sounds. So what I'll do now is I'll get the track set up, and we'll put it on some track, and crank it up again, and actually give it a run, see how it goes. Okay, back soon. Okay, so I've got the track all set up there. This is not my actual layout, it's just a couple of boards I put on the dining room table, and just use for test runs and running engines in and so on. So we'll crank her up and see how she runs. Here we go. I probably won't talk much over this, so we'll just let it go. Okay, so I'll give her a go without any sound, just so you can see how smooth it is. It's quite a smooth loco, runs very nicely at slow speeds. That's just at the first level speed, so you can see it crawls along very, very slowly. It's not really having any problems pulling those carriages along. And yeah, very, very smooth. So we'll just take it up a couple of notches. and just pulls out very, very smoothly. It's a really, really nice loco. It's powerful, it's very smooth, very quiet, and yeah, just really quite a nice loco. So take the speed up a little there. And a little bit more. And a bit more. A bit more. You can see she goes quite a speed. Probably you normally run her at this sort of speed, just so you can see what she is capable of. And there we have it at full speed. Let's slow it back down again. Yeah, so there we have it. It's the Class 37, 37409, Lord Hinton, in DRS livery by Backman. Excellent loco, great detailing, very smooth, very powerful, and just a really, really lovely machine. So very, very pleased with it. And thanks to Olivier's Trains for the sound as well. Beautiful sound on it. I'll probably try some sound from other people for other locos and so on. But for this one, very, very happy. Yeah, so basically I'll leave it there. That's the first review done, so of the Class 37. Just before I go, I just wanted to say thank you to all to my subscribers. I really, really do appreciate all the subscriptions and the comments and so on. Just hit the 50 mark, so I'll probably do a 50 subscriber special coming up. I've got an idea for that. Meanwhile, thank you to everybody that has subscribed. And all your comments and the people that watch them, it's really appreciated. So I'll leave it there. Bye for now.